The breathalyzer is only a screening device. It doesn't prove you've had too much to drink. It's just a guide to the Garthi to say that perhaps they should investigate the matter further. So, you've blown into the breathalyzer, and the crystals have turned from yellow to green. The Garthi thinks you may have a blood alcohol level above 125 milligrams. That's the new legal limit for drivers. He'll take you to the station, and there you'll be asked to give a blood sample to a police doctor. This sample will be analysed by the Medical Bureau of Road Safety. If the sample is over the 125 milligram limit, well, you're in trouble. Under the new law, it's a definite offence to drive or to attempt to drive when you're over the limit. And the penalties are the same as for the present drunk driving offence. That's a fine of up to £100 or 6 months in jail or both. And there's an automatic disqualification from driving for 12 months, just for good measure. Even if you're below the 125 milligram level when the Garthi stops you, you can still get yourself in trouble. For instance, if you refuse to take the breathalyzer test at all, well then you're liable to a £20 fine, and the courts could disqualify you from driving. Also, when you're brought to the station, it's an offence not to give the blood sample, but at the same time you can give a urine sample instead. But suppose you can't manage the urine sample, the Garthi can then demand a blood sample. And if you don't give it, you're liable to the same penalties as if you were above the 125 milligram level anyway. Obviously, the fact that you can't refuse a blood test without a penalty is going to cause some controversy, and it might even be tested in the Supreme Court. But for the moment at least, the law says you got to give a blood or urine sample if the Garthi want one. That's unless you want to face a heavy penalty. Now, the Act does say that you can try to satisfy the courts you had a good reason for refusing a blood sample. But it's worth pointing out that neither the Road Traffic Act nor the report of the commission which recommended the breathalyzer offers any advice on what a good reason might be. Still, if you think you've got one, the courts are willing to listen to you. But why a blood test at all? Well, the 1963 Commission on Drink and Driving felt the clinical tests on drunkenness, such as walking a white line and so on, weren't always reliable. They depended too much on expressions of opinion by the person carrying out the test. At the same time, the clinical tests may still be used, at least in theory. Of course, some people can take their drink better than others. So even accepting that the blood test is a good idea, why should 125 milligrams be the standard for everybody? The Commission agreed that alcohol affects different people in different ways, but they felt that most people's driving would be critically impaired once they went over the 125 milligram limit. Two members of the Commission disagreed with the fixed level idea, by the way. And the Commission felt it shouldn't be an absolute or defenceless offence to drive with more than 125 milligrams level. They should said you should still be allowed to show you were fit to drive. But the government decided otherwise, so once you're over the 125 limit, you've no real defence. Well, how are you going to know how many drinks put you over the limit? How many pints, or small ones, equals 125 milligrams? The short answer is, no one knows. The effect of alcohol on your blood depends on a number of factors. Your age, your sex, and particularly your weight. But as a very rough guide, according to Dr. Maurice Hickey, the state pathologist, it would take at least 2¾ pints, that's about 4 small whiskies, to put an 11-stone man over the limit. That's if he drank them quickly, and of course a fat man could probably drink a lot more. Again, that's only a very rough guide, and there are bound to be exceptions. You could be one of them. Apart from your weight, your level is also affected by the speed at which you drink. Generally, your body eliminates the alcohol in one bottle of stout every hour. Now, you could play it smart and have a quick drink from, say, a hip flask before you take the blood test. But the Act provides that if you do this just to avoid a prosecution, well, you're committing an offence. So perhaps the smartest thing would be to let somebody else do the driving.